Z-Dub here, and welcome to my initial review of Gears of War Tactics, just released today on Xbox One and PC. Now, this is available on Xbox Game Pass as well for only $5, which is an amazing value to play this game on day one. Now, before we get into this and talk about this title, make sure to drop a like on this video, hit that subscribe button and bell so you don't miss out on any of my upcoming content, reviews, and other gameplay tips. So here we are, a brand new game in the Gears universe, but it's quite a significant departure from the typical Gears formula third-person cover-based shooter that I would typically be interested in and that we're all used to seeing here. Now at first, I was going to pass on this title myself. I'm not the largest of a turn-based strategy fan. I'm more of a casual player when it comes to this genre, but boy am I glad I took the time to give this title a chance. Who knew I would absolutely love this? Now the change in gameplay really feels right at home here. The cover-based gameplay that Gears offers is matched perfectly to this genre, and what we have here is a fully fleshed-out Gears title. The story has depth, cutscenes, and gameplay that really makes me feel like I'm playing a mainline Gears title. Now, when I first loaded it up, it almost tricked me for a second and felt like I was going to play a mainline shooter. Now, let's touch on that gameplay. As a casual player, I did not feel overwhelmed here at all. There's the correct amount of hand-holding and training to get you off the ground and understanding how to do battle here. Once it clicks, it becomes super relaxing, engaging, and an intense experience all at once. I really didn't want to put this thing down, and that incredibly surprised me. There's a lot of depth here in the gameplay. With a large RPG-inspired skill tree, you can spec your characters out as healers, damage, etc. There's really a lot of different variations and builds you can do here to help you get through these engagements. There's several upgrades and modifiers that can be unlocked for your weapons, and you'll get new members added to the team as the campaign progresses. All that packed together really lends to a deep and engaging experience here for veterans of the genre and newcomers alike. Now, I really feel everything is super intuitive, and I never once struggled with the controls or interface. When you pull off a chainsaw kill, I had the exact same feeling I would get in a traditional title, even though the gameplay is so different. Now, with the variation of enemies, items, and encounters, I felt like there is not much repetition going on here, and this should hold your attention for quite some time. The campaign length weighs in at a whopping 25 hours for the average player, so that's an incredible value for the price that you're going to pay on this game. I mean, with Game Pass, it's only $5. Now onto the graphics. This game is visually stunning. The gameplay scene here is playing at Ultra, and I'd expect the Xbox One X version to be comparable to this. The frame rate and game engine, it's super smooth, and the textures, particles, and enemies are all super detailed. It's everything you would expect in a AAA title. I had zero technical issues, and the Xbox experience on the PC is seamless as well. So the big question is, if you're not a fan of this genre, but you're a fan of Gears of War, is there something here for you? Now I say the answer to that is a strong yes, and I highly recommend this title to veterans of the fans of the genre and casual players like me. Who knows, maybe after this I could call myself a larger fan of this genre, because I just love this game and the gameplay that's offered here. So as a final verdict, this is a great starter intro to turn-based strategy, and it's a great title to play. And at $5 with Xbox Game Pass, to me it's a no-brainer. So go pick it up, get your strategy fix, and turn into a newly converted turn-based strategy fan just like me. So thanks for stopping by and watching, and once again, make sure you don't miss out on any of my other content in the future, and hit that subscribe button and bell, and I'll see you next time. This is Z-Dub, out.